Hello everyone, this is Shelly and in today's video I'm going to review some of the products from the Korean skincare brand Purito. And if you guys remember some weeks back on my Instagram stories, I asked you people to vote for the brand that I should review first on my upcoming one brand series on YouTube channel. And I was not at all surprised that the brand Purito got the highest number of votes. Like, this brand is loved by people for many reasons. And people love their products because they use clean ingredients. Their products are vegan friendly. Like, most of the products are vegan friendly. And their brand is cruelty free. But first I have the Purito Defense Barrier PH Cleanser. This is a gel cleanser and it is 100% SLS free, SLES free and is paraben free. And honestly, like, this cleanser is something I feel that everybody can use it, except for the people who have very oily skin, because this doesn't provide that squeaky clean finish and most of the oily skin people are used to that. Otherwise, like, if you have like dry, combination, normal, sensitive skin, definitely give this a try. And plus, this also contains my favorite ingredient, Centella Asiatica, to calm down your skin. And it also contains tea tree leaf oil, which is an amazing anti-acne ingredient. But I do know that some of you out there are quite sensitive towards the tea tree oil, so you can skip on this. Otherwise, this is a fantastic cleanser and definitely a must try from the brand Purito. And next I have the Purito Centella Green Level Calming Toner. So this is basically your calming and hydrating toner. It contains 10% Centella Asiatica and therefore this toner like helps a lot in reducing the redness. And when I was using, I also noticed that if I had the tiny zit due to the irritation, it also calmed them down. And when it comes to the hydration part, I was not impressed over that side, because during summer and monsoon, when my skin is not in a much need of hydration, this toner worked really well for that hydration. But whenever my skin was excessively dehydrated or during this winter time, I didn't find it hydrating enough for my very dry skin. So this is why I feel that if you have like normal dry combination skin, this is going to be a fantastic toner for summer and monsoon time. Whereas like if you have oily skin, this is going to be an amazing toner all year around, except for that hot, humid monsoon time. But one thing I want to say, that if your skin is sensitive towards the essential oil, you can skip on this. Like, I will insist that you skip on this because it contains 4 essential oil. And instead of using this, you people can go for the unscented version, because their unscented version is 100% essential oil free. Next, I have the moisturizer from the same range, and it is the Purito Centella Green Level Recovery Cream. Now, this is basically your skin calming and barrier repairing moisturizer. Like, for that calming part, it contains 50% Centella Asiatica and its bioactive derivative, and additionally it also contains 2% of niacinamide. And for that barrier repairing part, they have used ceramide 3, cholesterol and good amount of fatty acid. So performance wise, like, I definitely liked this moisturizer overall. Like, when it comes to the calming part, it definitely worked for that. But when it comes to the damaged skin repairing part, over that side, I didn't find it much effective on my skin. And also, I do get asked, like, does this brighten up the skin or help in fading the acne scar? No, it really doesn't do that much. But if you have some redness, it will definitely work on that. And lastly, like, I wanna say that it does contain 2 essential oil, and if your skin is sensitive to these 2 essential oil, you can skip on this and go for the unscented version. Like, honestly, I'm so happy that the brand Purito, they take the feedback of their customers very seriously. Like, I remember when years back, when the Purito launched their 3 products from this range, like the toner, moisturizer and the sunscreen, All of three were made for the sensitive skin, and people complained that also it makes sense that most of the sensitive skins are allergic to the essential oil. So they took the feedback, new range, the unscented version range, they took out all the essential oil. Like, seriously, thank you Purito for listening to your customers. The next moisturizer from the brand Purito is the Deep Sea Pure Water Cream, and this is basically your hydrating, moisturizing and calming cream. And they have used 60% of seawater and 2% of niacinamide. Like, when I was reading about this seawater thing on the Purito website, I learned that according to the brand, the seawater has similar structure to that of our human body fluid, and so this is why this cream will be easily accepted by our skin and will therefore work faster at the deeper level of our skin. So overall, I feel this is a good moisturizer, and when compared to their Centella cream, this has a lighter consistency, and so this is why I feel like if skin that is more towards the oilier side, like combination oily skin or oily skin, that needs something to instantly hydrate and moisturize your skin, this is the product you definitely need to check out. One thing, like very interesting thing that I noticed about this cream is like whenever my skin was like red, slightly irritated, and it was like heated up. And when I applied this cream alone on my damp skin, that is right after using any toner, this instantly calmed down my skin and gave me relief from that rising skin temperature, that redness and itchiness. Since the product claims on brightening and whitening, I do get asked like, does it work on that part? I have not really noticed it. Like, this tube is like almost empty, there is barely any product inside. This like doesn't work in fading your acne scar or evening out your skin tone, but overall it will definitely help in calming your skin and making it overall healthy. And next I have the two famous sunscreen from the brand Purito. The first one is the Centella Green Level Unscented Sun with SPF 50 PA 4+, and this is their chemical sunscreen. It uses the chemical filter to protect your skin from the sun, and also it is essential oil free and fragrance free. And the second one is the Comfy Water Sunblock with SPF 50 PA 4+, and this is their 100% physical sunscreen. It doesn't use any chemical filter, and also it is like essential oil free and carrier oil free. And the other difference between these two sunscreen is that the Centella one provides a moisturizing finish on skin, therefore more suitable for the dry skin, and this Comfy Water one has a slightly matte finish on skin, therefore more suitable for the oily skin. And I honestly, like seriously, love both of these sunscreen. They are like so good. They don't leave any white cast. They are very comfortable on skin. Due to the controversy that happened few weeks back regarding the Korean sunscreen, it all started with the Purito Centella sunscreen. In case you don't know what I'm talking about, let me summarize things for you. Like, a few weeks back, an Instagram post came up saying that they did a test on Purito sunscreen, the Centella version, in two different and independent European lab, and the SPF rating, instead of 50, it came around 19, and this was a huge shock to the entire skincare community across the globe. It was then followed up with many unnecessary things which literally shocked me. Like, how can people be so rude towards a brand or to other people? Like, let me not just talk about it and stick to the point. And after all this happened, the brand Purito, they came up with the apology post, and they have said that they will do the testing of all of their sunscreen again before launching them in the market. So in the meanwhile, they have withdrawn the sale of their sunscreen. Like, I have seen people throwing their sunscreen out of the window and flushing their sunscreen in the toilet and whatnot. Like, if you people own either of these sunscreen, like, don't throw them away, keep them aside until further notice. Or like, some of you out there have been giving wonderful suggestion, like, use this sunscreen as your morning moisturizer. Like, what's wrong with that? It's totally fine. It's anyway not gonna harm your skin. and then if you want, like, you can follow up with another sunscreen. So this is what even I have been doing, thanks to you people, like, for such amazing suggestion. And next I have the BB cream from Purito, and in case you are shocked and you didn't know, the brand Purito does carry BB cream, and I have their snail clearing BB cream with SPF 38 PA triple plus. Now since this is a BB cream, it does not provide that full on coverage like that you get from the foundation. So this one provides sheer coverage, and you can build it up to 2-3 layers, and after that I really don't recommend layering, because then after third layer it starts creasing, and I personally layer it only 1 or 2 times, and that works for me. And for the finish, it provides that soft dewy finish, and I love dewy finish on my dry skin. And also I feel that if you have oily skin, you might not like this, because I know oily skin people love the matte finish, and if you have like dry normal combination skin, and if you are a fan of dewy finish, definitely check this out. And when it comes to transfer, this does transfer, especially if you apply it more than 2 layers. And so I suggest that after using this BB cream, follow up with a mineral powder or a setting powder. And overall, I do love this cream, and in fact, like, on most of my video you will see me wearing this only. I find it very comfortable on my skin, and most importantly, it does not dry out my skin, because I have seen if I use the typical foundation on a regular basis, I end up with badly dried out and dehydrated skin, something which I absolutely want to avoid during this winter time. So I have 2 shades from them. One is 23 natural beige, and the other one is 27 strand beige. And my max shade is NC42, and the shade 27 matches well on my skin. Like, it's not the exact match, but it works out for me. So if you are anywhere around MAC NC42, 42, the 27 will work for you, whereas this 23 one is more suitable for the fair skin tone. As you can see, like, this shade 23 has very prominently cool undertone, and this shade 27 has neutral warm undertone. Initially, I planned to make this video only after testing out all of their famous products, but due to some or other reason, I couldn't get my hands on them. And then when you guys voted for this brand on my Instagram story, I was like, okay, let me make the video with whatever I have, and in the future when I get my hands on rest of their products, I will make a part 2 of this video. So make sure to subscribe to my channel, and if you have any recommendation or product suggestion, leave them in the comment section below, and I will definitely check them out, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.